on Big Brother's Little Brother tonight, the two most attractive housemates ever to enter the Big Brother compound. I love you guys. Time. Hey, my friends, welcome to Big Brother's Little Brother. Oh, what a night! Yeah. Double eviction. We've got both of tonight's evictees here in the studio, Caprice and Jeremy. Yeah. Feeling very nervous. Also on the show tonight, Coronation Street Seller, aka Wendy Peters, is here. Yeah! Yeah. Plus, of course, the ever spectacular Big Brother's Little Brother binge drinking audience. Yeah. Okay, it was just over an hour ago, Caprice and Jeremy were given quite a surprise when they were evicted from the Big Brother house. Here is what happened.
Big Brother house, this is Davina. The fourth housemate to be evicted from the Big Brother house is... Caprice!
Oh, you lucky bitch!
I didn't see that one.
Ladies and jelly spoons, Caprice and Jeremy!
Hello!
All right, buddy.
You poor thing, are you not even changed yet? Never
He's
seen.
Such a good sport, I tell you.
Have you worn that T-shirt all week? Was it ever washed?
Well, no, yes. Yes,
yeah,
I washed it once.
I didn't see that.
But, you know, we had a lot of dressing up, didn't we?
Sure. You like the dressing up, too. I guess you must do. If you only got one outfit, you're going to say, give me the clown outfit. So how are we doing? What a kind of shock night, right?
No, can I tell you, it was a great night. I think we were all in the house hoping. We're like, come on, please be me. Please be me.
Well, I was watching most of the day today, and you, every single sentence, you were going, I've had enough. I just want to go now. I just want to go.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's a bit of a downer, to be honest with you.
Yeah, well, you know, it's kind of done now. For us.
Yeah. Did you expect to be... Well, when Caprice came out, did you think, OK, what's going to happen now? Am I going to stay till Sunday, or...?
No, that, I thought... No, because we thought there'd be one tomorrow night. Mm-hmm. But I didn't think there'd be another one tonight. Once Caprice had gone, hence I was sat there eating an apple, and then he suddenly said, Jeremy! And I was like, oh...
Are you a bit gutted, or are you quite glad?
Well, a little bit, because I didn't get to finish my apple. To be honest.
Yeah, that'll be the thing that really
sticks
in. But
other than that, I was very happy and, you know, hopefully I can get one on the outside.
Yeah. We don't have some sort of hilarious surprise worked out for you now. Now, everyone, you know, I have to ask this, everyone was hoping for a bit of, I love you, I love you, I love you, in the house.
No,
obviously,
no,
you two, no, just like, with whoever. I mean, you and Jackie, you and John,
Nice.
But you two were the prime candidates. So did you ever feel like, you know, when the old spin the bottle came round and the cider was out, you ever think,
no,
it's a long, lonely night?
No.
Dom, do you know, I went to bed.
Every single night. He went to bed by like 10 o'clock, 10:30.
That really annoyed Bez, didn't it? Because whenever anyone went to bed, Bez was like, oh, don't leave me. Oh, please.
He was up till
3, 4 o'clock every morning, Bez. Yeah.
Okay, now, what's the best thing about being in the house for you, Caprice?
You know what, I just think I was a bit, you know, it's a bit of a scary thing being with, you know, 9 other people 24/7. But you know, they picked a really good group of people, and I have some really good friends now.
I think the thing that sort of struck most people about it was how honest you were with each other, because most people in the house are well known, you're on television, you're celebrities. Yeah. Everyone expected there'd be a certain guard that was up. And, you know, within the first couple of days, mainly thanks to John, that was just totally stripped away.
Well, no, but there was a guard. I had a guard. I definitely had a guard. But when John came in and just lashed at me, of course the guard's going to come down. Mm-hmm. You know, I want to protect myself and what I believe in.
OK. Now, you bonded with the girls in the house. Let's have a look at the... Well, I'd like to say, put it differently, but gossiping that went on, Caprice. Take a look.
I'm such a girl's girl.
So having a burp. It's rumoured that she's going, but she did say this about those kind of shows.
This house, it's just, it really, really messes with your head.
Mm-hmm. First you give us John. Get the Bride of Frankenstein.
We'll have lunch or dinner, but we'll do that. Now we can really have a gossip.
Babe, proper, I cannot wait.
But it must be impossible when you're in there not to talk about other people. Because, I mean, it just must be the thing that's kind of on your mind all the time.
You know what the thing is you forget the cameras are there.
Are you serious?
No, you do. You do. I mean, no, the first week, maybe, you know, 5 days, you're very conscientious of the cameras, but then you just forget about it.
Yeah.
Then you just start talking.
To the point where, I mean, you were saying when that was playing that you just, this is the moment you realise that the cameras are on you all the time.
Yeah, because it is weird seeing it played back because you do forget.
You
fact.
Do.
You can't,
yeah,
you can't remember.
OK, now, Jeremy, what's your worst moment in the house? You seem to, you know, you're a big, Big Brother fan.
Yeah.
Was it what you expected?
It's a lot harder than you think. It really is, and I can't stress that enough, and I don't want to moan because it was fun and everything. It really was fun. The pros outweigh the cons, definitely, but it's real mind control, you know? You have to just get on and you have to just crack on, you have to put up with stuff all the time, you know?
Yeah.
You can't afford to lose your temper. My worst moment was when Jackie came in. That's not because of Jackie, but because I suddenly thought, what is going on here? You know, they're getting personal with Bridget.
Yeah.
And I strongly objected to that because I didn't...
Is that why you were so glad?
I was completely went into protecting Bridget.
And it's strange because we watched a couple of the psych shows and the psychologist always said, that, you know, in the street or, you know, or in the confines of your own home, you'd never be that nasty to an old lady. But when everyone was together, those rules were just out the window. She was just another person.
Yeah, I mean, it was just, I have to agree. Right? I mean,
how hard was it to be without clothes? Seriously, I know you. I know you're a man that adores clothes.
Yeah,
I,
you know
I always thought you went home and just burnt anything you'd worn more than
I
once.
I have really nice clothes as well.
And you do have lovely clothes.
Thank you, Dom.
Your
Thank
friends
you.
And family are over there. Benny, he's going to say, is he a vain man?
No.
Go on. Yes. OK, now, you and Kenzie became very good friends in the house. Caprice, I have to ask this because I've been put up to it. Last two men on Earth, Kenzie, a man who's malleable, the youthful vigour, or Jeremy, a man with 33-year-old experience. who would it be? Just think Castaway.
I know, this is the third time I've been asked this question, and,
Obviously me.
Yeah. Jeremy's actually sitting there going, it has to be me.
Well, she can't say anything else, can she? I'm sorry.
Okay, let's have a look at how the housemates have been coping since you left right now.
Tears.
Fucking listen to that chair. Be that chair then. That's incredible, that. I didn't expect that then, did
Man.
You?
Man! Hey. Two tonight.
We kind of guessed it, but I thought that was it then, did you?
You were gonna have a heart attack.
Oh my god, I was like this.
Does Big Brother remember that we are all like serious wine drinkers? That
yeah,
we need
man.
Like
we
six
need
bottles?
Wine.
No, three bottles, a bottle each.
Well, we want a bottle each, yeah. Yeah, all right, Kenzie, lad. Solid, man. Cease.
To be honest, I thought the last two people that we go tonight were Jeremy from Peace.
So pretty much shock.
Aww.
Especially from Ken's there. Now listen, Caprice, you speak to your mum six times a day. You said
Five,
it's the longest you'd have gone without talking to her. You must have missed her incredibly.
No,
right?
I asked for my mobile. The second I got out, I asked for my mobile because I had to call my mom. Yeah, she before I went in, she said, well, you just have to tell this Big Brother that I just have to talk to you. You just have to get out of the house and you have to talk to me. I said, well, Mom, I'm sorry. It just
doesn't work like
that. Sort of doesn't work like that.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, well, we've got a little surprise for you on the phone. She's on the phone now.
No, she's not.
Yes, she is. Oh. Hello, hello, Mum.
Caprice?
Oh. No. I'm Dermot. But this is Caprice. Hello, Valerie. How are you? You're right.
Oh, my mom.
I'm doing very well.
Okay. Valerie, you're over in the States. Is that right?
Yes, it is.
Lovely. Now, how do you think Caprice has done in the house? Have you seen anything?
Yes, I have.
Can I talk to her?
Yeah, of course you can talk to her.
I would say that I thought she did very well, except I thought that I was going to see my daughter when she stuck the knife in the toaster. I thought I was going to see my daughter electrocuted on the internet.
It was incredible.
In the
poster, see, I said, yeah. Did I not teach you anything, baby?
No, you did, Mom. Oh, Mom, I miss you so much.
I miss you too.
Valerie,
the sequestered stuff is not good.
Valerie, can I just say, I mean, would you miss her as much if you heard her potty mouth with language like this?
No!
I find that extraordinary. Are you going to lecture her when she gets home?
I thought she was quite calm.
Oh. Okay, Valerie, thank you very much. Nice to speak to you.
Bye, Mom. I'll talk to you later. Love you, Mom.
I love you, too.
I love you, Mom.
I've missed you so much.
I miss you, too, Mom. I miss you.
Valerie, in theory, this could go on forever. You don't need to prove your love to us. You're crying here. Okay,
no,
wonderful.
I'm okay.
Bye.
Bye, Mom.
Bye, sweetheart. Call me as soon as you can.
I'll call you as soon as... I know, I'll call you right away.
We're paying, Valerie.
Love you, Mom.
Boom.
Bye, Mom.
Boom. She's gone.
Okay, she's gone.
Woo! You were both fantastic in the house. Thank you very much for going on
Thank
there.
You
really
so
appreciate
much.
It. Jeremy, your mum's over there, so you can just go and talk to her without any charge from us whatsoever. let's have a look at your best bits. Hi, Free World! I love you all!
Hello. Right now, I'm on fire.
Looking for some shirts, looking for some peace. The fire and furnace is burning like a beast.
Right, let's see what I did there. Oh, there's so much love.
Come on!
It's got leather calm down. Do you ever get the feeling like somebody's watching you?
Guess who's up now?
I can't wait for the task today.
What? Come on. That's it.
I've had such a long journey to find myself.
Never had anal sex.
The hell was that?
Ladies and gentlemen, Caprice and Jeremy! Okay, still to come, Coronation Street's Wendy Peace is going to be here, and more, of course, from Caprice and Jeremy. We will see you in three. Hey, welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. Coming up, we're putting your questions to Caprice and Jeremy.
Oh, no.
And these two ladies in the middle here who want to speak to you as well. I'll call BBLB at the end of the show. My next guest is the only person to rival Bez as Manchester's the scariest export. Please welcome Courage, Wendy Peters. Hello, Wendy. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
It's nice of you to come on the show.
No, it's great. I'm
a big fan. Are you sad to see these two go?
Yeah, I mean, it's always sad when they go, but two have gone.
I know.
I mean, that was a bit of a shock.
Expecting that tonight?
No, not at all.
Excellent. So who's been your favourite up to now?
It's sort of gone a bit...
At the moment, it changes, doesn't it?
Yeah, at the moment, it's Brigitte. I just think she's not at all what I was expecting. I was expecting a slightly mad woman.
Absolutely.
And she is the most down-to-earth, natural mother. Mm-hmm. I thought she dealt with the Jackie situation with such dignity.
Yes.
She didn't rise to the occasion. And, you know, saying she wanted to go because she didn't want her kids to see, good for her.
It's the shock of Brigitte. You're right, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because you expect... When you saw her profile at the very start and she was just in Milan just kind of, yeah! chicken ah! And even when she came along the catwalk, and, you know, no one even really understood what she was singing, and yet she's gone in the house, and she hasn't. It's not like she's bottled it. She's almost just come out of herself.
No.
Okay. And what about a certain young man who's recently left the house? I know you had a certain soft spot on your heart for him.
Well, as John would say, in both cases tonight, you know, the totty's gone, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
You know? I'm going to miss him.
I believe you quite like him, in his tighty whities.
Yeah,
I'm
going to miss those shower shots.
Or indeed, well, just for you, we've got this. Take a look.
Great.
Well, I tell you what, I'm really pleased about the fact I've got no shorts, and I know you're not going to believe it. And I've only just realised that my white ones are completely see-through.
Anyway,
I'm all embarrassed now because he's just walked right past.
You're going to get a bit more embarrassed. Wendy, Jeremy, Wendy.
Oh. Yeah.
Let's see those tiny whities, Jezza.
You all right?
Thank you.
Yes.
I've bought you a little present.
Yeah.
Come on, baby.
Will you sign them for me?
Of course I will.
In many ways, Wendy, he already has.
There you go.
Okay.
Fresh out the sauna.
Now, Wendy, one of your favourite moments was when Jackie entered the house. Now, Jeremy's probably going to get flashbacks here, but I believe you do quite a good impression of her. Is that right?
I don't know if it's good. I think everybody's doing an impression of her at the moment, aren't they?
Okay.
Oh, you want me to do it?
Yes, please.
Okay, it's the way she sort of slings a coat over her shoulders. Look, yeah, it's Jackie.
Oh, I like that. Let's just see how that stands up with the real
thing.
See if it stands up with the real thing.
Yeah, I'm Jackie.
All right, Jackie! Oh, yeah. I love that. Now, do you think Big Brother's been particularly evil? You like the fact it's been evil, right?
Evil, yeah, although I don't think they've been that evil this time. I mean, there haven't been very many physical tasks, but there have been the wake-up calls.
Oh, the wake-up calls. Well, just for you, we've combined some of the best ones. Let's take a look.
Big Brother would like to serve you breakfast in bed.
That wasn't funny at all.
Jeremy, you yourself know you like a good practical joke. And
Yeah, I do.
What was the worst wake-up call?
That one.
Yeah.
No, actually, that's a lie. Actually, when we were doing all the hippie stuff, and they woke us up at like, about 6:30 with these chimes or chants or whatever. Oh, my
God. Do you remember the violin? We did that.
Remember it?
We did that.
It's ingrained. It's imprinted in my memory for the rest of my life.
That was us.
Going into therapy.
We chose a schoolgirl to come in and actually, the viewers actually picked her.
You're not doing yourself any favours,
Hinda. No, I'm not, am I?
Not whatsoever.
Have you been disappointed with any of the evictions?
No, I don't. Well...
That's a shame, because it says here...
Does it?
No, apparently I heard that you were slightly annoyed that Lisa went out because she was such a strong girl.
Well, yes, in as much I did like Lisa, because she said exactly what she thought, although her language was a bit ripe at times.
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of that going around.
But she did say exactly what she thought, and I was a bit disappointed that, you know, she didn't know what was happening.
What about me?
She came out in...
What did you just say?
Say it. Go on.
What's your point?
Go on.
What about me?
What about you?
About me? I mean, come on, I'm sat right next to you, woman.
I've said that already, because I've got the pants to prove it. But, no, I just thought, you know, dressed as Bo Peep, bless her, poor girl.
Yeah, I know.
That was harsh.
It was harsh.
You know, I think she's going to put a bit, you know, everybody else is going to be able to put a bit of makeup on them.
Yeah.
You know what makes me laugh here, though?
Change clothes.
It's the way the girls all put tons of makeup on to come out, as if they don't realise we're watching them 24 hours a day, aren't they? And they've all got no makeup on. And suddenly they come out with makeup.
OK, lastly, there are three housemates left. Who do you think is going to win? A little synopsis of all of them. First up, we won't go with Bez first up, we'll go with Kenzie first up.
I think Kenzie probably stands the best chance of winning. I really think he's the favourite. I mean, all the girls are going to vote for him. You know, he's
young. Were you surprised you got on with him so well when you were in the house?
Kind of. I had met him before, to be honest, on, like, kids' shows, you know, Saturday morning thing, and I always liked him. So that was good. But he did actually exceed my expectations.
Sure. OK, next up... Next up, Bez.
Bez is just fab. He's on a world of his own, isn't he?
I mean, you're up in Manchester all the time. Is Manchester really behind him?
Yes, definitely. Yeah, I was out last week in the pubs and they're all just, you know, really cheering for Bez. I mean, good luck to
And lastly,
him.
Obviously, your favourite.
My favourite.
You want Brigitte to win, right?
I really do want Brigitte to win, yeah.
OK, terrific. Thank you very much. Wendy! OK, three housemates remain, and there's only 2 days to go until one of them becomes a winner of Celebrity Big Brother 2005. You're voting to who you want to win, and these are the numbers. Okie dokes, today's Cool BBLB, which is Ask Caprice and Jeremy, is happening right now. You two will be taking some questions, just in case you're out. Let's go straight to the phones. I believe Gina from Shropshire is on. Hey, Gina.
Hi, Dermot.
Oh, I like your voice.
I'm great. And hello to all the beautiful people at BBLB.
Oh, I like it. What's your question?
My question is for Jeremy, and I want to ask Jeremy, do you think that taking part in Celebrity Big Brother will help or hinder your career?
This is interesting.
I'm thinking right now, hinder. I was hoping help, but now I'm thinking hinder.
Well, after seeing your bottom in the shower, Jeremy, I very much doubt it will hinder your career.
Were you guys really thinking that much about it?
Because, well, what can I say?
Well, I know you were thinking about it. Gina, we don't need to worry about that. Were you thinking much about it in relation to, well, what happens when I come out of this?
No, you just... I wasn't. I was just thinking,
no
just
way.
Let's get through today.
Yeah.
Or let's just get
definitely.
To the next hour.
OK.
Brilliant. Yeah.
Thanks a lot, Gina.
OK, thank you.
Thanks a lot for your excellent voice. Next up is Caroline from Basildon. Hello, Caroline.
Hiya.
Hi, Caroline.
Hi, sexy.
You.
No, he's you. OK, go for it.
My question's for Caprice. Hello, Caprice. Well
Hi.
Done. I noticed while you were in the house that you hardly wore any makeup or paid attention to your personal grooming. I was wondering, were you less bothered about your appearance than you otherwise would be?
Was that bad? Oh no!
No, you're right, you're beautiful.
You know what? You know what it is? You just forget the cameras are on you, and usually just when I'm not working, I have no makeup on, so I really didn't care less. I know I look horrible without makeup.
Oh, no, you're still gorgeous. I'm so jealous.
Oh, thank you.
Way to put it back there, Caroline.
I know. Well done.
Thought you were going off on one, then. Thank you very much, Caroline. Stephanie in Edgware. Hey, Stephanie.
Hi, Dermot. Hi, Caprice. Hi, Jeremy.
Hi, everyone. Hi, Stephanie. What's your question, hon?
My question is to Jeremy. Why are your lucky pants so lucky?
Well, yeah.
What
They're not actually
team?
That lucky, and I didn't even wear them.
No, we had them on here. We showed them on the show.
Yeah.
They're terrific pants.
I think they're great pants. They're just my favourite pants.
So they're not particularly...
Well, obviously not.
Tom from Lincoln, is it? Or Amy from Lincoln?
Tom and Amy, actually.
Hello. Oh, lovely. Well, welcome, both of you. we've only got a little bit of time, so what's your question?
Question to Jeremy is, if he could change anything that he did in the house or his experience in the house, what would he change?
The location. There's no pub.
What would you change if you could change anything about your time in the house?
You know what? I would want it to be bigger.
Yeah?
Much bigger.
And a gym, a pool.
And a tennis court, and ping pong.
And that is about it for tonight's show. You can catch the aftermath of tonight's Shock Eviction tomorrow, 9 p.m. on Channel 4. Caprice and Jeremy will be back with me 1 p.m. on Sunday with all the evicted housemates. And you know what that means. She's back. Do it again.
Yeah, I'm Jackie.
Jackie is back, ladies and gentlemen. Ex-EastEnders Chris Parker's also going to be here. Tune in for Davina at 9 to see one housemate crown the winner of Celebrity Big Brother 2005 from Crinkly Bottom. Goodbye! Yeah.